And welcome to Drive Time. I was Renner House, episode 38. Okay, it is the 22nd day of April. Yeah. April was not a good month. Okay, so then it's, you know, it's 8:55 Eastern AM in the Eastern Standard Time. I almost just ran over a bird. I'm driving my car. As you can see, it's a blue sky, some fluffy clouds. It's cold. It's got to be 40. It's not warm at all, really. So waiting for that warm weather. But I don't mind it like this because I think it's supposed to be like 50, 60 all week. But mostly sunny. I don't know if it's supposed to rain. I don't think so. Or not much or anything. So I prefer. I'd rather have days like this than 90 or high, you know, humid 80s. That's for sure. For sure. God. So last week was a difficult week for the nation. This is what I do in the show. This is my show where I talk to myself. This is the nation, the moral, morale is down. It's low. How do you say that? Oh, I just forgot. I just felt sick all of a sudden. Sometimes it happens when I get in the car in the morning. That's what that's all about. I am determined, without much of a plan, to have a better week. I think, you know, given all the events of the news last week, this is poised to be less intense. Get caught up in that shit, just in the internet, and the Boston Bomber Brothers. It's entertainment. It's a whole soap opera now. Now it's like, now that I know a little, I know the plot, I'm gonna pull back and say I don't need to watch the whole movie. Does that make sense? I advise people to do the same. I don't think it helps. To, you know, if some big story breaks out, I'll, you know, obviously check it out. If some big development that's interesting. And how can you not? It's like human nature. Still just streamlining things. In my personal projects, I had that one thing I was supposed to get done by 4:20. Not gonna happen, but I do need to get that done this week. That's, you know, that's the goal I set for myself, that I passed the due date, and there you have it. Not good. I freaking hate that. Mondays, you know? Mondays. I'm grimacing right now. I should just... The rest of this show, until I get to my office parking lot, should just be silence. But just know I have a I actually can't talk because I'm grimacing so hard. So just know that I'm picture a really good grimace. It's not forced at all, too. This is natural grimace behavior. I ran 10 miles yesterday, and I was actually a little hungover. I went to an aquarium, too, so, in the morning. My nephew, brother and sister-in-law, and, wife. Lovely. Camden, New Jersey. Recommend. But then I got home, and it was sunny. Beautiful day. And I ran 10 miles, out of the blue. I wasn't even gonna run at all. I felt tired and achy. But I got out there and I was like, I'll only run a couple miles. I did 3 or 4. Got going and I felt a sense of purpose out there. So I just kept doing it. I kept going and I ran for 10 miles. So I felt good. I feel better today than I think I would have ever felt if I didn't just go that whole, you know, get that crazy run out. You know, I feel like I don't sweat sometimes. If the humidity isn't right and I'm, like, say I'm slightly dehydrated, massively dehydrated, or whatever the circumstances be, there's a lot of factors that have to go. I feel like I won't sweat enough, and I feel like I sweat just enough because I ran so long. It was good that I ran the extra long, because if I don't feel like I sweat for whatever reason, it doesn't have to be the day after I'm done drinking, you know, or, you know, it could be any day. But if I don't feel like I'm sweating enough, I need to feel like I've sweat a shit ton. Because there's something about, like, my body feels better. It feels, like, cleansed. But I sweat an okay amount yesterday. For 10 miles, it was a little less than you would think. But I wasn't really, you know, I wasn't going crazy. Although, at the end, I did a sprint. And I had this weird feeling. I don't know what the fuck it was. It was, I sprinted the last, like, 100 yards. Like, I really did. I sprinted it. And I got done, I was like, alright, I could have kept sprinting. And I was like, how long could I have sprinted before I would have died? My heart would have exploded. What would have happened if I just kept running? And why didn't it feel more, like, taxing? It was a very odd run yesterday. After 10 miles, which I haven't run since in weeks, I haven't gotten even close to that distance. So I felt, I don't know, it felt, like, really weird that I felt so good about it. It felt like I could just keep going so far. I don't know. We can do it. Everything's okay. We're all going to be okay. That's really the moral of that story, is that keep a positive outlook. This week can't get any worse than last week for me, you know, personally, and just the world. So I'm saying right now, this week will be better for all parties.